Welcome, everybody, to Fall River, Massachusetts, here at Bishop Connolly High School, the site of today's NJCAA Region 21 matchup between Mass Bay Community College and your Bristol Community College Bayhawks, here as the Bayhawks open the season, their season opener here at Bishop Connolly High School. Hi, I'm David Cardoza, alongside here with Craig Salvatore. Craig, last year, the Bristol Community College Bayhawks, they ended the season on a 10-game winning streak, and they also became finalists in the state tournament and also in the Region 21 tournament. Yep. So what Bristol Community College is trying to do this year is do something they never done, and this year in the land of the lakes in a place called Rochester, Minnesota, that's where the NCAA championship, the NCAA tournament is going to be held.
Bayhawks already off to a good start. They're already 1-0 on the season. Like to see them improve to 2-0 on this game. So we'll see how they can do as tip-off is coming up.
All right, we're getting ready for the starting lineups here at Bishop Connolly High School. It's the home opener for Rob Delalu and crew. Rob Delalu in his eighth season as the head coach for the Bristol Community College Bayhawks. For the tip here, so apparently there will be no player introductions here. It's the season opener, the home opener. And as you said, Craig, BCC starting the season off 1-0 against Quinsigamon. Here's a tip in the Bayhawks' favor.
Here's the pass, dribbling it down
Marcus
the court.
Marcus McCarthy with the basketball.
Bench already starting with the defense chances. The Bayhawks looking to get some of the start here early.
Oh, yeah. And we get steps. Going to be steps in the Bayhawks. Yeah.
Calling a travel on that. Be a turnover.
BCC's bench always into it. With a chance of defense. On the drive. Dribble drive to the hole. Can't get it. Rebounded by Armani Baker, the sophomore. McCarthy pushes ahead. Here's a three-point shot. No good. Coming off. Tipped. McCarthy can't put his own shot back.
Rebounded by Mass Bay. They're taking it down the court. Guns pass back, shooting for a three.
Three-pointer, top of the key. It's good.
Good. That was made by
number 33, Colin Myers. Looks like we have a foul. We have a push-off here on Mass Bay. Inbounding for the Bayhawks is Quincy Pope. Kevin Desire back out to McCarthy. McCarthy in the corner to Mendez. That foul is going to be on number two, Craig Kyle Jimenez Fox. Pope. Here's Danny Mendez on the drive. Baker loves the baseline.
And he'll be another travel call. Be another travel call. Turnover again to the. To Mass Bay, the Buccaneers. Menace Fox with a slow dribble, passing it down.
Mass Bay up here early, here in the first minute and a half.
Menace Fox going for the drive, the nice pass, bobbled a little bit, but he recovers.
We get a foul away from the basketball on BCC. taking the ball out for Mass Bay. Zach Lobotwitz. Ooh, gets it underneath to Cameron Jimenez-Fox. Look out for Cameron Jimenez-Fox and his brother Kyle Jimenez-Fox. Mendez tried to get it inside to Desire. Lost
recovery.
The basketball. BCC being careless. Mass Bay going the other way. Three-point shot. No good this time.
He bricks it, and it's recovered by Danny Mendez.
Three-point shot, Mendez. It's good. And BCC gets on the scoreboard. Mass Bay run their offense. They try to get inside to the big fella. It's going to be a push. The push is going to be on Armani Baker. Armani Baker, the returning sophomore. It's going to be a foul as he pushed the big fella, Edwin Mises, the center, freshman center for Mass Bay. Here's Lobotwitz. Kicks it back out.
Menes Fox loses that one, but he gets it right back up.
Good defense by BCC.
Well, yeah, I couldn't either. They said that I'm on that.
Yeah.
I just dropped the score sheet.
On the drive, kick back out. Three-point shot. No good coming off.
Long
Mass
pass.
Bay with the offensive rebound.
That one goes into no man's land. Bristol's
and
ball
they're
now.
Say that's not, they're going to say that's on Cameron Jimenez-Fox. Off of him. Mass Bay in zone. 2-3 zone for Mass Bay. Here's Armani Baker, the returning sophomore. Drives to his left, puts it up with his right, and lays it off the glass and in. Nice move by Baker. Baker, one of the few returning players from Drobdell Lewis.
Meanwhile,
team from last year. That three is good. Is that a three?
It was a three by
a three.
Colin Myers.
Another three by Colin Myers.
Step back,
be
but
steps.
Calling him travel. He does not like that call.
Danny Mendez, a sophomore from Providence, Rhode Island, went to Central High School. Yeah. Won the leading scorer so far this year in the young Bristol Community College BayHawks season. Here's Lobotwitz.
Lobotwitz trying to show off his handles.
That's a deep three. NBA range coming off short.
And he bricks it.
Rebounded by Quincy Pope.
Good way to kick it to Mendez. He's able to recover as he's trying to drive to it. Slips up.
Mendez out of control. BCC playing sloppy with the basketball right now.
They just need Desire to have.
Desire's going to lose it to the big guy, number 55, Mises.
The BayHawks need to have patience right now, and they're just not showing it early on.
It doesn't seem like they're running their offense. You're right.
And Mendez Fox just trapped, gives it away.
Driving to the hole is Lobotwitz.
One for the jumper.
Sloppy basketball by both teams. Dan Mendez with the rebound, with the basketball, taking it to the hole, drops it off.
Good pass.
Offensive foul.
He hit the ground hard on that one.
Mendez seems to be playing a little bit out of control right now. Checking in for the BayHawks is going to be Desmond Jimigan. He's a freshman forward from New Bedford, Massachusetts, coming in for Kevin Desire. And also coming in for the BayHawks, checking in is Chad Nguia, who's also a freshman from New Bedford, Massachusetts. He comes in for Dan Mendez. BCC playing a man-to-man. Colin Meyer gets it down into the big guy. Here's Big Edwin. Jump hook, no
puts
good. Nice little pivot move, nice little move down the block, but couldn't get it to fall.
Jernigan with the boards, and there's a deep pass.
Nice pass. Quincy Pope gets it on to number 10. Chad Anguilla.
That's good fundamental basketball right there. Good layup to tie the game with 15 left in the quarter.
7-7 early on, 15 minutes to go here in the first half. And there's going to be steps there on number two. Kyle Jimenez-Fox.
A lot of travel calls already in the first 5 minutes. McCarthy bringing it down.
Drop it down low. Nice move.
Playing a game of keep away right there.
Down low to Baker. He's good.
Nice pass. Nice score. Taking the lead.
Baker, not the biggest of guys, but for a front court player at his size, he plays bigger than what he stands at. That's for sure.
The good thing about small guys in basketball is they're quick, and he has that agility to get right under the hoop to score.
While Lobotwitz getting very, very sloppy. Trying to go around the back and go on the other way as number four, Desmond Germagon, to lay it up and in. Errant pass there by Zach Lobotwitz going behind the back, and then Desmond Germagon came in to pick it off and take it the other way.
I'll tell you, that's a great recovery there for a guy who almost just fell on his face.
Ooh, dribble drive going to his left. Puts it up with his right. No gone. Good. He's going to go to the line, though. That's number 23, Cameron Jimenez-Fox. I guess he's not going to the line.
No, he's just going to have to pass it in. Clutching his neck a little bit, though. Up and over to nobody.
I don't know where that pass is going to. Mass Bay lucky to have it.
Yep.
Jimenez-Fox for three.
Just
no
short.
No good. Number 13 for three from the side. Four. No good.
Pass back and gets the boards.
McCarthy drops it off to number four, Quincy Pope. No good. BCC maintains possession. New shot clock for BCC.
Just lost it.
Loose ball. Mass Bay coming away with it. Down on the other end. Lobotwitz puts it up and in.
That point was wrapped like a
Rob
Christmas
Dale
present.
Rob going to call a timeout. So after the first 7 minutes here in the home opener for Bristol Community College, the home team does lead 11-9, but some sloppy basketball here in the early going for both teams, Craig.
Yeah, the Buccaneers did get lucky on that last point, though, just getting that breakaway ball with the offensive player just able to break away and score on that easy layup.
That's for sure. Well, in this young Division III NJCAA Region 21 season here in the early going, Rock Valley, they are the defending national champions. They are the number one ranked team in the country. They were the preseason number one. They won last year's championship in New York. They're followed by Rochester, who was the preseason number two, Eastfield, Vermilion, and Herkmeyer. Those are the top five teams coming into this season. This year, Craig, the national tournament will be held in Rochester, Minnesota, the land of the lakes. It's moving from upstate New York, where it was last year and in previous years. So that's what Rob Del Lue and his Bristol Community College Bayhawks are striving for. They've never been to the national tournament. They've been this close. They've been so close. Last year they were finalists against Bunker Hill in the Region 21 championship game, but they weren't able to get over the hump. This year Rob Del Lue is hoping his Bristol Community College Bayhawks can do something that they've never done, and that's make it to the national tournament and have a chance at a national championship.
Well, this game is still young. They still have the chance to go 2-0 in the season, which will definitely take them on that way to Minnesota.
That's for sure.
Yeah. Oh, just
and coming out of the timeout. That's not what you want to see. Going to the other end.
Oh, what
it.
Was that? Someone greased the balls earlier. It's two quick losses of possession right in a row by both teams.
Good job by Marcus McCarthy to knock it away from behind. Seemingly, that's what happened.
Tried a no-look and didn't really get anything from it. Almost lost it, but he was able to hang on to it.
We got 17 on the shot clock. BCC playing good defense. Oh,
Lobotwitz with the drive, though, able to get the layup for two.
Lobotwitz is a good little player. 11-11. McCarthy to Quincy Pope. From the top of the key, that shot is no good by Germagon. No.
Number two, Kyle Jimenez-Fox gets the boards. He's trying to pass it down to Danny Mendez, but there's a call on the court.
It's so much better when I can hear you in my headset, Craig. I'll tell you that.
It does tend to be a good thing.
Communication is key as we get the kinks out here in the early going.
That it is. And I know a lot about communication as I major in it, but it's a little bit different. But anyway, here's the pass in, so Lebowitz takes it.
Justin Davis over to Meyer, tried to get it into the big guy. He was denied by Desire, but he threw it out of bounds.
There was just no effort on that one. Didn't even try to get it. Didn't risk it to try to throw it back in. Just let it go out of bounds, and Bayhawks really need to capitalize on this in a tie game.
Here we go. 11-11, 12 minutes to play here in the first half. Home opener for the Bayhawks. Nice denial by the big guy, number 55, Mises.
Very lazily just swats it away out of bounds.
Yeah, very lazily. But Kevin Desire didn't really wasn't really aggressive on that when he tried to get the basketball.
Deep throw. Well, both teams are definitely frustrated with the way they're playing early on. There's a jumper from
Germagon, two. Germagon, no good. There's a deep three, no good. Air ball. Going back the other way. Intercepted. Oh. Intercepted by Kyle Jimenez-Fox. Going back the other way.
Quick turnovers, turnovers left and
McCarthy right. McCarthy trying to lay it in. He'll lose it out of bounds.
They might be calling a foul on that one.
Will they finally call a foul in the act of shooting? They do. McCarthy will step up to the line.
There's a foul on number five, Justin Davis. So McCarthy will get two right now. Looking to break the tie.
Davis will miss the first one. If you're just joining us here on FR Media, channel 95 on your dial of the Comcast, this is David Cardoza and Craig Salvatore on the call. And this.
He's able to make the second shot, take a quick score, 12-11. Playing aggressive defense now. Trying to get a quick turnover. It just throws it off the shin. That's a message right there.
This is like what BCC likes to do. This is what BCC likes to do when they're on their game.
Play that man to man. That one.
Play that man to man. That man to man press there. Causing stress with the other team.
See, this has been the problem for both teams right now, and the Buccaneers are really showing it now, is they're just rushing things. They're not making sure that their teammates are set, ready to catch it. Instead, they're just losing it.
Triple drive. Two is left. McCarthy gets it to Germagon, trying to go underneath, loses it. McCarthy ends up back with the basketball. McCarthy for three, no good.
But
tipped
almost,
up.
Almost tipped in.
They're going to call a foul on number four there. They're going to call a foul on number four, Josh Bonney, sophomore guard for the Bucks.
So Pope will take it, pass it in.
Here's Germagon at the top
of the
key.
Ups to get that.
McCarthy back out. Here's Desire. Try to get it to somebody. Bonney going the other way.
He's wide open.
Bonney, coast to coast, lays it in.
Almost tripping over himself. I love the effort by Bonney being the only one staying down there.
Exactly. 13-12. Both teams not generating a lot of offense here.
I'm not sure what the turnover was called for.
So Mass Bay will inbound at the half court line. Here's Bonney.
Davis with a long bounce pass.
BCC in man-to-man. Bonney trying to lay it in to the big guy. Gets denied. Oh. There's a lot of back and forth. Eight on the shot clock. Bonney. Meyer. Loose ball. Here we go.
Covered by Bristol, deep throw.
Hard to keep up here. Intercepted by Fox. Fox going the other way, through defenders, up, and can't get it to fall, but he'll go to the line. Goodness gracious.
A lot of action going on in these last few minutes.
That's for sure. Can somebody count the turnovers? Both teams being very, very careless with the basketball as Jimenez Fox will step to the line. This BCC crowd too quiet with Mass Bay shooting free throws. You think the, you know, can I get a yell? Can I get a holler? Can I get a scream? Can I get a toe tap or something?
Maybe they can start doing the wave.
Something. Goodness.
Jimenez Fox going for his second shot if he missed the first one.
The quietest home crowd in history. Jimenez Fox misses both free throws. Rebounded by Germigan.
Falls down. He's in a struggle because he couldn't get up.
You're watching Basketball Follies. Dribble drive to the hole. Germigan lays it in. Nice pass by Quincy Pope to set that one up. Germigan with a nice strong drive to the hole, laid it off the glass.
Probably the most exciting layup I've ever seen.
And what do we got there, Craig?
College basketball. They're calling something downfield.
Looks like an offensive foul.
Well, Jernigan's going to take it back.
We got some substitutions. Danny Mendez going back in the game, and also number 20, Luis Rosario, freshman from Orcovis, Puerto Rico.
This ball gets quickly taken out now, but it'd be Bayhawks ball once again. Jernigan getting to the out-of-bounds line to throw it in.
For the Bayhawks, Jernigan's in there. Danny Mendez.
Mendez, good job breaking
Luis away
to
Rosario,
get that.
Armani Baker, and number 13, Quincy Pope, all in the game for the Bayhawks. Mendez on the drive.
Throws it
out of bounds.
Trying to take out a man on the bench. It's not very nice.
Rob Taylor Lou beside himself. Here's Josh Bonney. BCC and their patented man-to-man. Spinning off the glass. Gets it to go. Nice move by Kyle Jimenez Fox.
With that, they're able to take the lead with nine remaining.
Here's Danny Mendez. Mendez loses control of the basketball again. Nice hustle play by Josh Bonney to get that basketball back.
Man, I've seen less back and forth in tennis.
It is like a tennis match. My neck is going like this, left to right.
I can't even keep up with the amount of turnovers right now.
Mass Bay, that's a deep three. And it is good. Nothing but net.
Honestly, when he took that one dribble, I really thought he was just about to hit it off his foot.
Well, Kyle Jimenez Fox with a huge three right there. Mass play playing inspired defense now.
Went for a big drive, but just got eaten up right there. But looks like it'll be a foul. Foul on number 4, Josh Bonney, it looks like.
Josh Bonney will step out. Number 1, Zach Lobotwitz will come in and take his place.
Danny Mendez will take it from the line, take 2 from the line.
Mendez in the season opener against Quinn Sigamon had 21 points. He hits the first end of a 1-on-1 here. BCC is in the bonus. 17 fouls on Mass Bay. 6 on BCC, so Mass Bay near the bonus as well as Mendez sinks both free throws. LeBeau is being closely covered by Mendez. Another turnover by Mass Bay. That ball goes out of bounds.
Couldn't tell if that was out of reach or again, just no effort by number 55, the big man. He has the biggest reach. You'd think he'd be able to get to that, but couldn't quite see how far away that got.
Yeah, both teams just being careless with the basketball. On the drive, putting it up is no good.
Yep. It's a loose ball again, recovered by Pope.
Mendez needs to get into this offense, set this offense up, get his team good looks. In the corner for 3, it's good. Quincy Pope for three in the corner.
And the crowd loves it.
And finally, we get some cheers from the crowd as the BayHawks take a one-point lead, 19-18, 8 minutes left.
You can do that when you get a game, when you get a go-ahead three.
Jimenez Fox with a little shake, gets it to the lane, gets the up fake, no good. Nice rebound there.
Jimenez Fox put some shoulder action in that one, but didn't get anything.
He had a good little shake move there. Mendez
on the
top of the key. Lobotwitz off the glass and in. Nice drive by the little fella. Both teams trading leads now. Danny Mendez. Mendez being guarded by Lobotwitz. Lobotwitz jarring at him. Germagun gets it. Gets it swatted away by the big fella Mises on the other end.
Wide open.
Oh,
wide open,
Kyle,
like
Jimenez
a 24-7
Fox.
Bar.
Wow. All right. All right. As we take a timeout here, 22-19, the guest, Mass Bay Community College Bucks have the lead here, 22-19. And Craig, it seems like both teams just can't hold on to the basketball, but right now, BCC, they're playing good man-to-man defense, and that's something that they take a lot of pride in, is playing that man-to-man defense, especially when they play a full court. That's kind of been a big sticking point for them since I've been watching these BCC games.
Yeah, their defense has been doing pretty good, especially with the mistakes the offense have been making from the Buccaneers. But the BayHawks just aren't able to take advantage right now, as they're showing some sloppy offense here and there too.
Yes, sir. It's the Jimenez Fox brothers. I mean, the last game for the Mass Bay Community College Bucks, Cameron Jimenez had 30 points. His brother Kyle Jimenez Fox had 25. So those guys are two big stalwarts for the Buccaneers, who come in averaging 91 points a game. Only 22 here today, though, after 13 minutes of play.
Well, Cameron Jimenez is the Buccaneers' leading scorer in this game right now. So they're definitely relying on him to put on a performance. And basketball is one of those sports where one guy can really make a difference. We've seen in the NBA just LeBron James turning Cleveland from losers to winners just like that, not once but twice. So one player definitely can make a difference.
That's for sure. It is a team game, but you're right. One or two players can make a difference. Mass Bay looks to be in a 1-3-1. 1-3-1 zone. Here's a trap in the corner. Ooh.
Nice
BCC,
pass.
BCC, you get to pass the ball on the zone. Mendez. Quincy Pope, that's his corner shot. It's good for three. Line drive three by QP. Quincy Pope ties the game at 22.
That's Pope's second three-pointer of the game.
On the drive, number 14. Can't get it to go. Loose ball.
Mass
Bay kicks it back out, but it goes the other way. Mendez up and can't get it to fall. The layup is no good.
He's not going to get a foul call on that either.
Lobotwitz drops it off to number 14. It's going to be Steps. Steps will be called on number 14.
Yeah, big time up and down on that play.
Who is number 14? Because we don't have him listed here.
Maybe he's a late addition to the team.
He's a late addition to the team.
Yeah.
He's a ringer.
These are new roster sheets.
Anyway. BayHawks, nice drive. Lays it off to Germagun. Passed by Quincy Pope.
Sometimes that's all you need, just a nice lazy two. All the points still count the same, so you don't have to be the flashiest, but as long as it's effective.
Sorry, that was McCarthy with the pass to Germagun in the lane. The big guy, nice move.
Ooh.
Up and under move by Edwin Mises. The big guy. 24-24. Lay-in. Oh, nice block. Block was by Fox. Jermigan puts it up, no good. Rebounded by Baker, tough inside. Got three guys surrounded him. Here's a three-point shot, that's no good. Rebounded by Jermigan, who puts it out the glass and in. 26-24. Under five to play in the first half from Bishop Conley. On the drive to his left, strong move, up and under and good. Kyle Jimenez, Fox, a freshman, puts it up and under, and his brother picks him up.
He's a little shaken up on that play, but he'll get the end one.
But that play ties the game. Strong move, driving to his left. Somehow goes up and under, puts it off the glass and in. Kevin Desire coming in for Jermigan. Jermigan.
Yeah, Desire definitely coming as a defensive replacement as he's considerably taller than Jernigan. And it pays off as he gets the boards right away.
No three-point play there by Jimenez Fox. BCC coming back the other way. We get a tight one. Ooh. Oh, nice move by McCarthy to get it to the lane. Nice left-handed pass to Desire with the soft hands. Puts it up off the glass. 28-26. Both teams trade in leads. Lobotwitz at the top of the key. Little stop stutter. Back to number 14, the mystery guy. And that's for the second time.
I'm calling steps on him.
Gonna be steps.
He is mad. He is frustrated. He had a wide open shot. Could have shot for three, even say he tried to go in, bank it for two. It just didn't pay off.
Gotta put that ball on the floor, Craig.
He is still frustrated. See, basketball, you got to have a quick memory. You're going to make mistakes, and he's hanging on to that right now. It's going to hinder him.
McCarthy, nice bounce pass.
My God, I hope everyone has their plane tickets. A lot of travel calls here.
So that was another travel. So inbound to the basketball are the Bayhawks, are the Bucks. BCC sit back in zone now. Here's the big guy, too strong. And it's going to be a foul on the big guy, number 55, Edwin Mises. The big center freshman. You see on that play, Craig, with a big swing. He gets the ball down low and swings his elbow. You just can't do that.
No.
He doesn't need to do that. He's so big and strong.
No, you got to use that body.
Just use that body. Take a drop step and use that body.
Inside of McCarthy. McCarthy hands it over.
It's a new look Bayhawks team. McCarthy, 15 on the clock. Got to move the basketball. Got to come to the ball. Going baseline is McCarthy. Somehow puts it off the glass and in.
He had all five guys on him, and he was able to work around that. That was a nice shot. Beautiful play.
McCarthy's starting to get off. Spinning in the lane is Jimenez Fox, and it's good. These Fox brothers are good. 30-28 now. 3 minutes to play in the first half. We're starting to get into it. We hope you're into it here at Bishop Conley. Baker at the top of the key finds McCarthy. Seems to be the go-to guy now. Being guarded by Lobotwitz. And it's going to be steps on Desire. We've seen a lot of steps. Get your step tracker out, ladies and gentlemen.
It's not a lot of good ball handles going that game, whether it's just losing it or just getting called on travels.
Lobotwitz crosses over.
He's showing some nice handles there.
BCC in the zone. Driver to his left. Him and his Fox puts it up and under. Can't get it to go. This time it's Cameron, him and his Fox, a sophomore.
They're calling a foul on Desire here.
I lost the other sheet. It dropped down. I haven't been able to keep score.
Yeah, that's all right. Don't worry about it.
All right, stepping to the line is Cameron Jimenez Fox. Both teams have 18 fouls.
And that is
an air ball.
I've heard nothing but net, but that's not what they wanted. Now the crowd taunting him for that air ball.
About time. About time somebody taunts somebody for something.
They'll pay him back, though.
Second free throw is good. 30 to 29. Here's McCarthy. Going to go to his left. Puts it up. I don't think he wanted to do that. Rebounded by Cameron Simmons Fox.
Passed it
going
to his brother.
Going the other way
He's
to
driving.
His brother. Kyle puts it above the glass. Those two use their brother system. 31 to 30.
Smart by desire to get in right away. Waste no time getting the ball back in play.
Here it is for three. No good. Quincy Pope with the miss. That ball was rebounded by Colin Meyer. Here's Cameron, the sophomore. Josh Bonney.
They'll be calling another foul on this one.
I believe that was, though. I'm sorry, Justin Davis on the drive. And they're going to call an offensive foul?
Looks like it. I believe it was on Davis on that. I believe they're calling charging on it.
So they will call a foul on Justin Davis. 31 to 30. Two of the higher score teams in Region 21 held to only the 30s. Seen a lot of sloppy play.
We almost just saw an example of one, and now
and
we just
got more
did.
Steps.
Oh.
This time it's Chad Nguia looking to the ref like, what did I do?
I feel a lot of players are feeling the same way as him right now. He's getting a lot of calls, and he's going to let him hear it. And timeout.
Timeout on the floor. Timeout on the floor for the Bucks. So Mass Bay calls a timeout with a minute 43 left. Both teams in the bonus. 19 fouls for the Bucks. 18 fouls for BCC. And, both teams, like I said, are a couple of the higher scored teams in Region 21. Both teams, very sloppy basketball. We've seen some good defense, but a lot of turnovers. It's 31 to 30. And we have a timeout on the floor here. So Craig, what does BCC need to do to pull away in the second half as they are not playing good basketball here? What do we need to see from BCC?
They need to focus more on teamwork because right now they're just throwing the ball away, taking their head out of it. Just a lot of balls just slipping right out of their hands. They need to get a good grip on it and be able to communicate better, be able to sink some baskets. Something that else they've been doing is a lot of times you've been seeing them not take jump shots. You see them go down low to try to get a layup, and that hasn't been working. They haven't been getting the fouls they wanted. They haven't been able to take the foul shots they wanted. And they just need to be able to take better action in their jumpers instead of keep going down low for the layups.
It seems like the continuity on offense isn't there. BCC's defense is usually always there as they force a lot of turnovers, but both teams are beating themselves. Here's Lobotowicz. Here's Fox. Loves that spin move.
And this one doesn't work.
And they're going to call steps on him. We got to start counting these travels because it's getting absolutely ridiculous.
Well, you can foul out. It's a good thing you can't travel out.
If you want to learn how to travel kids in basketball, you're watching the right game.
He's breaking out some dance moves right there.
Yes. Dance fever here at Bishop Conley. Mm. Okay, so BCC is actually in the double bonus. 10 team fouls for Mass Bay. So every foul from now on that Mass Bay creates, BCC will be shooting two.
Quincy Pope with the first shot.
And he'll drain it. And that will tie the game.
Minute 20 left. You know they love to take the lead, even if it's just one by 1 point right now.
It would definitely give them something positive to go into the locker room with, even despite not playing good basketball, especially offense.
Now one of the Fox brothers is going to take a seat.
Both free throws drained by Pope. Here comes that trap. Here comes that half-court trap by BCC. Lobotowicz gets it into the corner to Meyer. Fox, dribble drive, kicks it back up to the corner to Justin Davis for the shot. No good. Under a minute to go. Davis just takes it away. Took it away from Nguia.
See, we were talking about some of the problems here. It's that they're trying to do too much. You see him trying to fake him out so much rather than just passing it or just trying to take a step back and pop a shot. He's just trying to do too much to fake him out.
And it looks like right now Mass Bay is going to be in the double bonus. So step up to the line is Justin Davis for two. I'm sorry, for one. It's a 1-1. I'm sorry. He'll make the first free throw. The next foul by BCC will put Mass Bay in the bonus. So second free throw was good by Davis. And again, we see another lead change.
Desire wanted to hurry up. Less than a minute left in this quarter.
Justin Davis. Look at Justin Davis all over. Oh, my goodness. Well, what a drive. That was Quincy Pope. Justin Davis was all over Quincy Pope, but Pope took him to school. That ball's going way out of bounds into the third row.
And the fan gets a nice souvenir, but he has to give it
back.
For
a second.
Timeout called, 21 seconds left.
All right, so Coach Rob Del Lue is in his eighth season, Craig. Rob Del Lue has built this program, you know, from the moment he's been here. This has been his program. This has been his baby. And he's done a great job with it. This team has, they finished number two in Region 21 last year, finishing as finalists in the MCAC state championship tournament. And also they finished as finalists in the Region 21 tournament. They were one game away from going to the NCAAs in New York. So that's one step where Rob Del Lue would like to take this program and send his team to the land of the lakes up in Minnesota. I think that's the goal for this year's team. As they, the last few seasons, they've been so close, but yet have been able to get over the hump. So
definitely would love to win that first ring this year.
Definitely, definitely bring a title back home to the, you know, the good old Mill City of Fall River. 20 on the clock. BCC can hold for the final shot here. Here's McCarthy.
Mendez all up in McCarthy's face. Excuse me, that's Lebowitz. Mendez is our number one.
In the corner, that's Quincy Pope for three. No shot, and it's going to be more steps. They call steps on Pope?
Looks like it.
Apparently. 3 seconds, Mass Bay has to go the length of the court here. They do. Lebowitz is going to get a shot. The shot is up. The shot is good. Ooh. At the buzzer. And Mass Bay takes the lead at the end of the half. Much to the dismay of Coach Rob Del Lue.
Only 1 point, though, and there's a lot of basketball left.
And we talk about BCC taking the lead going into the half as something positive to take in despite the poor play. And the shot there by Zach Lebowitz at the buzzer gives Mass Bay the lead, but we have a lot of basketball left to be played here at Bishop Connolly High School. The score, 35-34, Mass Bay. We'll be right back after this for the second half here at Bishop Connolly in Fall River, Massachusetts.
Always the most exciting basketball is close basketball. You know, blowouts can be fun, but you just gotta love a good hard-nosed game.
That's for sure. Mass Bay is coming off a 1-1 weekend at the New Hampshire Technical Institute Tap-Off Classic. And the Buccaneers suffered an 85-74 loss to Williamson College. And in their last game, they defeated Northern Essex 108-93. With him and his brothers, they were immense in that game. Second half action ready to start. McCarthy gets the ball to Quincy Pope. Loses control of the basketball. That ball's going to go out of bounds. But it's going to be in the favor of the Bayhawks. So that must have been off of Colin Meyer, it looks like. He was the closest one to that play. Inbound to the basketball to Danny Mendez. Mendez loses control, and we have another travel.
He is not happy with that call. He thought he got shoved to the ground on that one.
That's for sure, Craig. The tail of the first half was what? Traveling. Not sure what the call is here.
Looks like they're making him retake it out.
what they're doing. We're going to do a do-over. All right, second half underway. If you're watching us on FR Media, if you're watching us on live stream, good evening, everybody. We got a good one for you. Going down low. God, he passed up a good shot there. Loose ball.
This is a good interception there by Pope.
Going back the other way, Mendez. Kind of a wild shot there. Kind of a wild attempt at a lay-in there as he couldn't get it to go.
You see, I brought this up earlier. This has been the Bayhawks' big problem is they're just trying to get too fancy. He could have had an easy layup, but he went under the hoop to try to get it in.
Didn't need to do that. In the corner, there's Mendez for three, and he makes it. He needed that.
It's a good way to make up for it. Why get two when you can get three? And
definitely did. And on the other end, it's McCarthy knocking it away. BCC bench getting into it. Colin Meyer to inbound for Mass Bay. Region 21 matchup. Oh, nice give and go there.
Looks like they're calling a foul on that one, and they are. Is a foul calling number? I believe that was Desire. They draw the foul.
Kevin Desire, second-year player for Robdell, Luz Bayhawks team. Cameron Jimenez steps to the line for two. Here in the early going in the second half, 37-35. Bayhawks took the lead on a three-pointer by Danny Mendez in the corner. And now Jimenez Fox looking to tie it on this free throw. This is Cameron Jimenez Fox. This is number 23. This is a sophomore. This is the older of the two Jimenez brothers. Sinks both free throws, tying the game at 37. McCarthy, dribble drive to his left. Try to sneak it underneath to Armani Baker, who loves the baseline but loses the basketball.
Threw that one behind the hoop on that shot attempt.
A little bit of confusion here. Quincy Pope in the corner to Desire. Desire at the top of the key. Drive it to his left. Trying to get it to the paint. McCarthy pulls up at the elbow, makes the shot. Mr. McCarthy makes the shot, 39-37. Labawitz going down the other end. Kicks it back out. There's a three. Cameron Jimenez, no good. Rebound by the big fella, number 55.
That is where height really comes into advantage, being able to grab the boards like that. And it's another foul on Desire.
Desire giving up a lot of height and a lot of weight down inside to Mr. Edwin Mises, number 55, the big center, the big freshman center for Mass Bay, who's a monster down there. Colin Meyer back out to Fox. Back to his brother, the other Fox, the little Fox, going up, and no good. But it looks like he'll go to the free throw line.
Little Fox, I like that.
The little Fox. How about big Fox, little Fox?
It's a good way to tell him apart.
Yeah, that's.
He's not going to take this from the line.
I guess not. Labawitz gets it underneath, the slam! The slam for the big guy, and he gets a Mass Bay bench.
The bench is excited.
All riled up. The big fella bringing the house down. Drive it to his left. Mr. McCarthy, a bounce pass underneath. Gets it to Baker. Lays it in. Strong move by Armani Baker. 41-39. Labawitz, little shake, little shuffle. From the top of the key, no good. Loose ball. Quincy Pope with the rebound.
Pope almost fell out of bounds on that one.
But he maintained his balance. Baker couldn't go baseline. Bayhawks look more controlled as they set their offense here. Desire from the elbow. Can't get it to fall. Rebounded by Cameron.
That was the right
the
call.
Box.
Just couldn't get it.
More steps.
Desire is really mad at that. He really wanted the foul call on that one.
Desire needs to control his emotions a little bit. Coach Rob Del Lew will take him out. Desire will check out. Number four, Germigan.
Number 33, Kyle Myers, appears to be limping a little bit. Here's maybe some back tightness there as he's clutching his back. But looks like he's going to be staying in this.
Number 4, Desmond Jernigan. Jernigan is in the game for Bayhawks.
That was a technical on Desire. Got his emotions got the best of him, slamming the ball down.
You got to keep control of your emotions. I don't think it was that big of a deal. It's early on here in the second half. There's no need for it. Lobotwitz sinks 2 free throws, sinks 2 technical foul shots. I mean, that ties the game.
We're only 2.5 minutes into this half, and Bayhawks have 4 fouls. I believe 3, maybe all 4 of them are on Desire. And we're only 2.5 minutes into this.
Got to keep those emotions in check. You know, sometimes technical fouls like that, sometimes that attitude can change the tide of a game. Mm-hmm. McCarthy directing traffic, being guarded closely by Lobotwitz. Mendes being guarded by Justin Davis. Mass Bay getting right in the Bayhawks jerseys right now, playing some tight defense. 12 on the shot clock from the top of the key. McCarthy drains it with Justin Davis all over him. Here comes the Little Fox coming right at somebody.
Ooh.
And it's going to be a foul. It's going to be a foul on the Little Fox. Mm. And gaining position was number 13, Quincy Pope.
Just too aggressive on that. That was a very smart play. They were able to get it off quick. They were able to catch the Bayhawks napping after a big play like that. And they thought, hey, I can just drive this down court and I can get an easy layup to tie it back up, but just too aggressive.
And you could tell Craig, he was making a beeline right at him. I mean, make a move. Mendes from the wing rolls out. Pope trying to get in there, but he couldn't maintain control of the basketball.
I like that little hot dog action he had. He kept the arm up like he knew he made it.
He almost did, but you got to be sure. Bayhawks coming out with their trap. Coming out with their pressing half-court defense. The big fella. Back up to Lobotwitz for 3. He stepped. I don't know what's going on.
I don't know what these refs are expecting. Maybe just to glue their shoes to the ground or something.
Glue their shoes to the ground. You got to put the ball to the floor.
Got to get Michael Jordan's magic shoes or whatever they are.
Michael Jordan did a lot of traveling in his day.
Yeah.
But he's Michael Jordan, so. Mendes. Kicks it back out. McCarthy. Back out to Mendes at the wing. Short. Rebounded by the big fella, Edwin Mises. Justin Davis doesn't have the numbers. Going to take it to the hole anyway. What a block.
What a block.
What a block by Desmond Jernigan from behind.
Call him a Twitter hater because he just got blocked.
I like that. And the Bayhawks bench getting into it now. Oh, inside, pretty move. Nice inbound play. The feed from Lobotwitz gets it to the big Fox. Mr. Jimenez Fox, Cameron, with the lay-in, ties it at 43. 43-43 with 15:50 to go. Oh, underneath, nice.
Nice.
Nice play by Quincy Pope to maintain his balance and put that one in. On the block, the big fella. Nice bounce pass underneath, but we got more steps.
I've seen less steps on an escalator.
<laughs> 45-43. 15:30 to go. McCarthy. Now Mendes. Mendes, fall away jumper. No good. Almost. Jernigan with the follow. Couldn't get it to go.
I don't know if he went for a tip-in or just tried to grab possession.
Lobotwitz from the elbow makes it. Zach Lobotwitz, the little fella, number 1, tying it at 45. Well, we've seen many, many lead changes here, Craig.
Nice little small ball right there.
Oh, it picked up by little guy Lobotwitz. Going to the hole. Puts it up and in. I don't think they're gonna count the basket. The foul's gonna be on the floor. Looks like it's gonna be on, was it on McCarthy?
They were calling 23. I don't know if that's Jimenez Fox or that's McCarthy.
They're going to call it on 23, Marcus McCarthy, the freshman from Providence, Rhode Island, went to LaSalle Academy. And they're going to call it on the floor. They won't count the basket, so we're still tied at 45. Seems like the referees are confused in this game, too.
Like, called something right away just as the ball immediately went in.
And I'm not sure about that. The refs just didn't seem like they were ready.
Looks like just a reset on the play.
Another do-over. Mises gets it across to Fox. Now Davis, back to Fox at the top for three. Got it. Bing, bang, boom, Fox. 48-45. Big three by the little Fox. That's Kyle Jimenez Fox, number two.
Good pick and go.
Desmond Jernigan on the drive. Gets it ripped away. Loose ball. Coming away with this Lobotwitz. Lobotwitz stops at the free throw line for two. No good. Bayhawks will look to push it back and now slow it down. Desmond Jernigan back out. Baker driving to his left. And there's going to be a foul. Blocking foul that's going to be on Cameron Big Fox, Jimenez Fox. Going to be a blocking foul on him. I'm not sure, you know, how many fouls that is on Cameron, but that's a couple now.
Nope. Baker will take it at the line, though.
Unfortunately, we're doing this game without the help of a statistician. But 48-45, that's all you need to know right now, ladies and gentlemen, with 13:57 left to play at Bishop Connelly High School in Fall River, Massachusetts. Here in the home opener for the Bayhawks, the Bayhawks come into this game 1-0. They finished last season with 10 straight victories in the regular season and also went to the finals in both the state and regionals. So Bayhawks actually on an 11-game regular season win streak, looking to make it 12 as Armani Baker steps to the line. Armani Baker was an integral part of last year's team. Sophomore player puts it up and in. Armani Baker, one of Rob Del Lue's key front court players from last year. He'll miss that free throw. Pushing his Fox. God, he's so fast. Pushing it all the way to the end, but couldn't finish. And they're going to call a foul.
Looks like it was a foul on Pope on that one, and it is.
Pope. I like that name, Pope. And that will be a foul. That will be a shooting foul. 16 fouls already on the home team. 16 fouls for the Bayhawks already, so Mass Bay is so close. They're very close to the bonus right now. One more foul committed by the Bayhawks will put Mass Bay on the bonus. Free throw made by Fox. 13:51 left.
We have seen Mass Bay calm down a lot. They haven't been getting nearly as many fouls as they did last time.
Yes, the tide has turned because we're looking at the Bayhawks committed 16 fouls already. They're in danger. I'll put in Mass Bay in the bonus. Here's Pope going to his left. And there's going to be more steps. I think Coach Rob Del Lue is going to have a dribble practice. Mm-hmm. It's going to be going back to the basics. Left, right, dribble. Three-man weave, you know.
Mm. Sometimes it's the basics that can get you.
That's true. Bayhawks in man-to-man. They'll get it down low. Cameron being guarded by Jernigan. Base move. And the foul is going to be on Desmond Jernigan. He doesn't like it.
Yep. The seventh foul already. Majority of those belong to Desire, but he's sitting right now.
It seems like every time the Bayhawks commit a foul or there's something that is not in their favor, they get a little mouthy. They get a little like, you know, it's focus on playing the game.
Again, basketball is that game, like I said, where it's all mental. Well, most of it's mental.
It's all mental.
Especially with how quick-paced it is, and the fact is you just got to have a quick memory. You make a mistake, you just forget about it, you go right back to it, you recover.
Most definitely. And it's also a game of emotions. You just can't let those emotions get get the best of you.
No, because you know what happens when you let emotions get the best of you? You play sloppy.
That's why the great players like Larry Bird and Michael Jordan, some of the legendary players, some of the most legendary trash talkers, they could get underneath your skin. They could take you off your game.
But they could back it up.
And they could back it up, too. In the corner. That was a miss by number 10. Rebounded by Kyle Jimenez-Fox. Driving to his left. Kicks it back out to Justin Davis. Justin Davis will now take it to the hole. Puts it up, running up and in. Justin Davis, number 5, with a strong move to the hole.
And from the look of this, Mass Bay is starting to run away with it.
Not just yet, Craig. 13 minutes left to play, 54-46. I've seen BCC fall behind before. There's a lot of time to play on their home court. But right now, Mass Bay starting to feel themselves a little bit. And it seems like this half has been played a little bit more under control. We're still seeing the traveling calls, obviously. We're still seeing the blatant traveling. But Mass Bay has gotten themselves together a little bit, Craig.
I'm sure both coaches on both sides are able to, in the back, just sit their team down and be able to say, like, listen, you guys can play good ball. You both are capable of playing good ball. You just got to calm down and play the way you know you can.
And it's only the second game of the season. I've talked to Rob Del Lu at the end of last year, and he says basically, you know, he bowls the season down into, I believe, 3 or 4 parts. You get the preseason, you got preseason basketball, you know, training camp, and then you get the first half of the season, you get the first couple months, November and December, you're still trying to find yourself, and then you got after the Christmas break, January and February, you know, you get the second part of the season, and then you get the postseason. So he basically boils it down into 4 parts of the season, and generally his teams are slow starters, you know. So this is only the second game of the year. They are going to get the kinks out. BCC, they started last year off kind of slow. They were kind of a 500 team. And then the second half of the season, like I said, Craig, they went on a 10-game winning streak to end the season and to finish as one of the top teams in Region 21. So this is just a learning curve, I'm sure, for Rob Del Lu. He's got a whole new squad here, except for a few players.
Of course, the difficult thing is just getting chemistry, especially with so many freshmen on the team from all over the place. They got to establish that chemistry, know what works for what player.
McCarthy. Oh, nice pass inside. Gets it to Jernigan. Ooh. Almost had it. Couldn't get it to go, but he'll step to the line for 2. But that was a nice play by McCarthy to find Jernigan through all that traffic.
That was a foul on the big man, their third team foul of the quarter, of the half.
Well, they got a long way to catch up to Mass Bay, that's for sure. Mass Bay already in the single bonus. Danny Mendez will come in. And who will he come in for? He'll come in for number 10, Chad Neguia. Danny Mendez back in the game in the backcourt for the Bayhawks. Bayhawks trying to cut into more of this lead. Free throws seem to be a problem, too. BCC not hitting their free throws when they do get a chance to get to the line. And they're not getting to the line that much.
They're calling another foul.
It's going to be a loose ball foul on the rebound. That's 18 fouls already on the Bayhawks. So they Bayhawks are in danger. 2 more fouls, Craig. And the Bayhawks are going to find themselves in a world of hurt because the Bucks. They're 2 fouls away from being in the double bonus, and the Bucks will be shooting 2 free throws from here on out. And there's almost 13 minutes left to play here. Free throw made by Cameron. Jimenez, Fox.
You'll be able to see the difference between the 2 Fox brothers. As you see, Cameron definitely seems to be the shooter of the brother, where Kyle, he's so fast. He's small, but he's so fast. He can just fly, get easy layups, and break away super easily.
You got that right.
You've seen Kyle, he loves that spin move, able to fake out his opponents.
Here we go, BCC. Pope going to his right at the free throw line. Oh. Gets it to go. Big shot by Pope.
He's telling them to bow down to the Pope.
There it is in the corner. Justin Davis, 4-3. No good coming off. Mendez with the rebound. Here come the Bayhawks. Mendez. And there's a travel.
Mendez does not like that. Didn't even look like Mendez took a step, and they're calling a travel on him.
But I think he's catching it, and he's, I mean, I don't know. I mean, it looked close. I'm not sure how you call that, but I can see how it can, I can see how it can look like a travel. We've seen so many travels, how can you not call it, I guess? Here comes a trap by the Bayhawks. Davis, cross court to Cameron. To Kyle. No good. Loose ball. Jernigan's going to come up with it and then lose it. And then Davis will step out of bounds, but nice hustle play by Justin Davis.
Nope, they're calling a foul on it. As I foul on Justin Davis.
Oh, they're gonna. Oh, it's a foul. Okay, yep. So a foul on Justin Davis, number 5. McCarthy, ooh. Trying to shake Lubowitz. Gets it to Pope. Pope back out to Baker. Oh, nice play. Nice pick move by Justin Davis. And then he steps out of bounds.
Nice steal,
nice hustle play by Davis.
It was kind of a late call on that. Kind of looked like he wasn't too sure about the call on that. It was the referee.
Well, stepping out of bounds?
Yeah, he was like already down under the hoop by the time he called it.
Yeah. Driving to the lane, driving to the right. Pope can't get it to go. Baker trying to muscle his way in there, loses the ball. And Davis, Justin Davis will walk it up from Mass Bay. The Bayhawks back in 2-3. Here's Lubowitz. Over to Kyle Fox, trying to get it to his brother inside. He gets denied. Picked off by Mendez on the cross-court pass. Fox. I really wish we were counting how many travels.
Yep.
Someone has to be counted somewhere. Another travel. That time on cameras, him in his box. 56-49.
Saw before, Mendez again just trying to do too much. Went for a little behind the back action, but just lost possession.
Driving to his right. McCarthy gets it up and in, and they'll count it this time. And McCarthy will go to the line, trying to get the old-fashioned three-point play. Marcus McCarthy.
So Mass Bay starting to catch up with fouls now.
And the Bayhawks are horrendous. Horrendous from the free throw line.
Huge miscommunication by Mass Bay.
Davis, the floater, no good. Rebounded by him. Who was that?
The Pope about Jernigan, to sit on his throne. But nope. It's too bad. That would have been a good call.
BCC. They'll get good looks going to the hole sometimes, but they don't always connect, and they're missing free throws right now. So those are key points in the game.
They're bobbling the ball a lot, too. They're just not able to get their handles as they are trying to drive down. They're just kicking it.
Cross-court pass. Who's that? Justin Davis for 3. No good. Rebounded by McCarthy. McCarthy, looking to take it to the hole. Kicks it to, gets it to Jernigan inside, he'll kick it back out. Coming up on 10 minutes to play. Mass Bay bench starting to get into it, they're allowed. Oh, nice little delay move, puts it up and can't get it to go. And they're gonna be going to, it looks like McCarthy's going to the line on this. And you're right, Craig, Mass Bay starting to commit some fouls, so they're going to be approaching the BCC looks to approach the single bonus for right now.
Some substitutions here as Lubowitz will be taking one out.
Zach Lubowitz out. Underneath to try to get it in!
You were saying before, I thought it was going to the line, but nope, taking it from out of bounds, but works out in their favor.
Works out in their favor, and now they are going to the line. Try to cut it to within 2. Nice inbound pass there by Pope. Quincy Pope to Desmond Jernigan. 9:52 to play. And they cannot make a free throw.
Yeah.
How many missed free throws that the Bayhawks have missed?
So that got to be at least 7.
It's unbelievable. That's the difference in the game.
Yeah.
Here's the little Fox being guarded by Pope. Double foul there. Both teams are going to be in the bonus now. Foul call is going to be on number 55, the big guy, Edwin Mises, and on number 14, Armani Baker. Those two going at it underneath. It's going to be a double foul. Both teams are going to be in the bonus now. 19 fouls for the Bayhawks, 18 fouls for the guest Mass Bay Bucks. Bucks looking to take the ball underneath their own basket as Kyle Jimenez Fox underneath. There's the inbound play. McCarthy tried to get to it. He couldn't. Kyle Jimenez Fox in the drive. Toss it in the corner to Davis. Loose ball underneath. Can't get it, number 14, the mystery player.
Nice lob
McCarthy.
Right there.
You gotta keep possession of the basketball. Jimenez Fox rolls it up. No good. His brother's there to clean up the mess.
Dude, it's the brotherly connection.
There. The brotherly connection.
Right there.
9 minutes to go. Armani Baker. And let's see if he's got it in the act of shooting. Either way, he's going to the free throw line.
Gone on 55 again. His fifth of the game.
If that's his fifth, he's out. Bye-bye.
Yep, and he is going to take a seat.
Bye-bye, big guy, number 55 with 5. And that's going to be it. That's going to be a big. That could loom huge for the Bayhawks. You get that middle, that guy, that big presence in the middle there. For Mass Bay, he's gone. You take him out of the equation. Now BCC can look to drive the ball underneath and get some intense underneath the basket.
He definitely put the mass in massive. So now we'll see what the Mass Bay Buccaneers can do without him.
Yeah, he's a big cog that takes up a lot of space. He's definitely an intimidating presence down there. You take it at that guy. I mean, you keep taking it at that guy. They haven't been able to be successful. Now you take him out of the equation. Might end up being a little bit more successful with dribble drives going to the basket. Because they missed a lot. The BCC's been missing a lot of layups, and I think a lot of it has to do with number 55, who's out of the game. Lobotwis.
Especially only down by 4 with a lot of game
down
left.
Down by 4. Number 14 throwing it over the basket. Not in the basket, but over the basket, and BCC will get the basketball back down 4.
We saw how it was early on, especially with Desire, just how emotional it was and how rough it was getting, just fouls left and right. Now the tide has certainly turned as Mass Bay has gotten the last 5 fouls.
Definitely crazy. BCC trying to be patient with the basketball. 12 on the shot clock. Going to the hole is Mendez. Loses control of it. Cameron Jimenez Fox comes away with it. Bounce pass to Lobotwis, who loses it. That's Jernigan with the basketball. Mendez going down the other end with the left hand. Can't get it to go. Loose ball on the floor. What is going on here?
It's like a pinball game right now.
Pope for 3. No good. Push off by Fox. And it's going to be a foul on Fox. Big Fox, and the ball is going to stay right here in BCC possession, Craig.
Big Fox is 4th.
Big Fox is 4th. Now, Mass Bay has already lost their center, the freshman, Edwin Mises, the big guy, number 55. He's out of the game, and now Cameron Jimenez Fox, their sophomore star, is on the verge of being out of this game too. He's got four. Free throw finally made by the Bayhawks. Desmond Jernigan gets the first one to go. So you started to say, Craig, that BCC was almost on the verge of getting blown out the gym. There's a rebound by Pope, who puts it back in. And that was a one-point lead, Craig. BCC was down 54-46, and now they find themselves down one. Here comes the trap by the Bayhawks. Fox puts it in.
Pretty movement on that one.
Fox ends up with the basketball and ends up putting it in.
Yeah.
Up three. McCarthy. Around the perimeter goes the Bayhawks. Naspe in that zone.
And that's a foul called on him.
Who did they call that foul on?
It was on number four. That was on.
They're going to call that on Jernigan.
It was Jernigan, yeah.
Desmond Jernigan.
His fourth of the game, too. One more and he's out. But, yeah, the Bayhawks have done a good job coming back. It was only down by 8 points, but it did just seem that way because it almost seemed like Mass Bay was scoring every time they had the ball for that short time.
It did seem like they were losing control.
Yeah, especially.
That ball goes right out of bounds.
They're probably just overthinking. They're getting overconfident. They're trying to be too fancy with it, and it's just costing them.
Mass Bay trying to come up the road. Number five is in the game. Devontae Holloway, another freshman from Salem. Went to Salem High School.
Looks like he'll be in this game for the first time.
Yes, sir. Loose ball. Stolen. Going the other way is Kyle Jimenez-Fox. He'll lose the ball.
Oh, they do not like that call. They're saying that one of them, either Pope or possibly McCarthy, tipped it away to go out of bounds, and it's going to be Mass Bay's ball, but they are arguing. They are arguing big time right now, saying that Fox just lost it.
You know, it was a good defensive play. BCC clearly came and knocked it out of bounds. I'm not sure if it was McCarthy or who it was, but someone knocked it out of bounds. More steps. More travel on the call.
It's a rare jump shot by Little Fox. Haven't seen him take too many of those this game.
Driving the lane, kicked it back out. Quincy Pope at the free throw line, makes it. That's his shot right there, going up to that free throw line. He drains it.
It's effective. It's bringing him within one.
Home team within one. Almost go. It's out of bounds.
Airmails that one.
Craig, for the last few years, BCC's signature, the signature thing that they do is that press. So they start playing that tight defense, man-to-man, full court press. They start trapping in the half court. They start making things happen. They start getting deflections. They start getting in the passing lanes. They start disturbing the other team. The other team starts to stress. They start to put pressure on the other team, and this is what they do. They cause turnovers, and I think that's what you're going to see down the stretch. Down one, the visiting Mass Bay Bucks coming in here to Bishop Conley High School, feeling the pressure against one of the top teams here in Region 21, it looks like. And BCC will put the pressure on you. That's what they do. If you've seen a Rob Del Lue team, you know they'll throw that press at you. They'll trap and really cause havoc with that.
Yeah, Coach Del Lue, he has five returning players coming back and definitely remembering what helped them last year and definitely adding to that, hoping to get a winning season this year and take that trip to Minnesota.
Definitely, there's going to be a lot that's going to happen between then and now. Obviously, we're here in early November. Everybody here, it's election day. Don't forget to go out there and vote. Big day. Big day here in the USA, but it's a big day right here. It's a home opener, 60-59. It's going to be a barn burner. So if you're watching a live stream, don't turn it off. If you're watching on FR Media on Channel 95 or Comcast, don't turn off because this is going right down to the wire. I'm David Cardoza here on the play-by-play here with Craig Salvatore live from Bishop Conley High School in Fall River, Massachusetts.
Yep, like you said, big day, big game. We'd love to see a big win.
That's right, here in game two of the season.
We have 6:17 left in the game. We got 60-59 in favor of Mass Bay.
Both teams now, Craig, in the double bonus. So both teams will be shooting two free throws from here on out with the, you know, when the other team commits a foul, it's going to be a double. It's going to be a double bonus. It's going to be a double. It's going to be two free throws from here on out.
And we'd like to see the Bayhawks take advantage of it, but with just their free throws in general, they haven't been able to. They've been missing a lot.
Free throw shooting definitely been poor. That ball is going to be deflected. Deflected by Lobotwitz. Going to go off of him.
And they're calling a foul on this.
Is it a foul?
It looks like it.
I think these referees are confused. I thought the ball was just out of bounds, so they called a foul away from the, wow.
No, it's foul on
someone. Armani Baker.
Ooh.
The foul's going to be on number 14. The foul's going to be on number 14, who we do not know who that is, the mystery player. Mm. Let's just call him mystery because he's not on our roster.
Nope.
Armani Baker.
He can't get the second one.
Can't get the second free throw. Kyle Jimenez Fox, the little Fox, taking it up court. Thought about three, doesn't do it. In the corner, the jumper, no good by Lobotwitz. Rebounded by Quincy Pope, who gets it to McCarthy.
Nice no look pass to Pope.
Look at that shot right there.
Oh.
Rolls out, can't get it to go. That's his shot too. I tell you, Quincy Pope and McCarthy look like brothers out there. Mm. The same hairdo. Going inside. Him and his Fox. Here's a trap. Lobotwitz drive it to his left. Puts it up. Off the glass. No good. But it'll go to the line for two. That foul's going to be on number five, Devontae Holloway. Freshman forward.
Just into the game. It looked like he was trying to get the benefit of the call, trying to get a charge call, but it just didn't go his way. And now Mass Bay has a chance to go ahead.
60-60. We're deadlocked.
61 now, but yeah, it was 60-60 with 10 fouls each.
Exactly. Make some noise. We're starting to hear a little bit. We're starting to hear a little bit of something. Both free throws made by Lobotwitz.
And silences the crowd right there.
Not hard to do,
nope.
Craig. Not hard to do.
Not at all.
Silences the crowd. Wait, they're already silent.
No, but the Mass Bay bench is going crazy.
There are a lot of people in the room right now. That ball is way, what's going on here?
I don't know what he was going for. Maybe he was looking for a lob. Maybe he was going for a lob, looking for a tip-in or something, but he just airmailed it.
I think he was trying to throw it to the basketball gods. That ball goes out of bounds. 62-60. Mass Bay looking to spoil the home opener for the Bayhawks.
I tell you.
Lobotwitz.
This is Pope definitely just throwing up a prayer.
I like that. Pope throwing up a prayer. Mm. That was cute.
Thanks. Anyone needs any one-liners, I'm available. Catch me roaming the campus at BCC.
Start your own one-liner blog there, a website.
I should write for Ernie Johnson.
Here's the mystery player at the line. Sinks the free throw. Nice form. Probably some of the best form we've seen at the free throw line by either team today.
It won't be a mystery for long if he can keep contributing.
That's for sure. Yeah. Both free throws made. Nothing but net. Number four, Desmond Jernigan, will come in for number five, Devontae Holloway. Number four, Desmond Jernigan. In the basketball game, along with number 23 with the basketball, who is Marcus McCarthy. McCarthy. Back to Pope. Under five to go. Down four, the home team. Quincy Pope to Baker. Drive it to his left. Puts it up with his right in.
Beautiful.
How did he do that?
Kissing the glass like it's a first date.
In the corner, Davis back out. Ooh, that
late
was a
reaction.
Scary pass by Mass Bay there. Got away with one.
It looked like Lebowitz didn't really know what to do.
Mass Bay trying to move that zone. Picked up by Mendez. That was big. Stay in control of it. Stay in control of it. You don't need to do anything too quick if you're the Bayhawks. Stay within yourself. Smart basketball. Baker gets it in the corner to Jernigan. Air balls it. Loose ball on the floor. Lebowitz will come away with it. Falls to the floor.
He's going to get some serious court burn. You could hear the screech of the skin.
What is going on? Loose ball on the floor. Whose possession is it? It's going to be in the favor of the Bayhawks, it might look like. And no. The referee says no. It's going back to, it's going to stay here. It's going to stay here for Mass Bay. Man, it's hot in this gym. I don't know how Rob Del Lue wears that fleece, that sweatshirt over that shirt and tie there. He must be sweating his you know what off.
He keeps all the coolness in his beard. That's how he does it.
Goodness gracious.
There's still confusion, it seems, on the court.
A lot of delays.
The refs
it's like
might.
It's like we're watching the NFL.
And in the NFL, definitely being way more strict now with celebrations. Dubbing it the No Fun League now.
The No Fun League.
Yep. Ratings are down for every team except the Patriots because we have the best fans.
That's for true. That's true. Here's Lebowitz. Bayhawks in their zone.
Ooh.
Three
risky
on the
pass.
Shot clock. Lebowitz goes up, puts it up, no good. Rebounded by Baker.
Foul
and
call.
They're going to the line. The Bayhawks have been miserable from the free throw line today, but these are probably the two biggest free throws yet so far. So these make these two count.
Yeah, makes all the both rest of them, it's all tied.
All the rest of the sorrows go away. Make these, make them when they count. Baker.
You just got to remember in basketball, it's not how you start, it's how you finish.
That's for sure, and he gets that to go. Clutch free throw. Has a chance to tie it. Armani Baker, the key sophomore veteran. Starter from last year's team.
The
ties
other,
it up when it counts.
Other
64-64.
Bench. 64-64. Mass Bay bench cheering for him to fail, and he shuts them down.
Shuts them down.
Puts it out of
here
park.
Here comes that traffic defense I told you about, Craig. Here comes Fox.
I don't know if he went for a pass or just straight up lost it.
It doesn't matter because they're going to call a foul on Danny Mendez, and Kyle Jimenez Fox will step up to the free throw line for two shots. 3:30 left to go on the contest. If you're just tuning in, it's been a wild one. We've seen a lot of turnovers. We've seen a lot of travel calls.
The Bayhawks trying the same thing now, trying to cheer for him to fail, but it's not working.
Well, I guess if nobody else will.
Maybe they should cheer for him to make it and he'll miss.
Both free throws made. Two clutch free throws by Fox on that end.
Loose
ball on the floor. Who's this going to go to? Fox on the floor with Danny Mendez. And the ball will stay here. I'm not sure how. I've never seen in college basketball or professional basketball where the bench is cheering for the other team to miss it. But I guess in a situation like this where your home crowd is basically non-existent, silent, I guess you got no choice.
I think Desmond Jernigan just fouled out on that last play. I believe they were calling the foul on number 4, and I think they just threw him out.
That's a shame because he's been a good little hustling player for Rob Del Lue's squad. 66-64. We'll keep it right here. It's a timeout on the court. 3 minutes and 26 seconds left to play. So like I said, this game is going to go down to the wire, Craig. Both these teams have had past experiences where they play down to the wire. They played in some barn burners the last couple seasons, and especially right here at good old Bishop Conley. So this is no different.
Hart.
I tell you what, Mass Bay is fast. Guys like Zach Lebowitz, Kyle Jimenez Fox, a freshman guard, brother of Cameron Jimenez Fox, and Justin Davis. They got these. Just Josh Bonney. They got a fast team. They push the ball up and down the court. And that's why they're averaging 91 points per game. They get up and down the court real fast. You know, they minimize those turnovers. They stop the travels. They'll be a lot better off. But they seem to be a lot more coordinated and have a lot more continuity.
I tell you, Kyle Jimenez-Fox really sticking to his name as he's able just to fly down the court.
Yeah. Here we go. It's crunch time, ladies and gentlemen. Pump that went right to the lane. Little delay move, and that puts it up and in. Rolls it out the fingertips, gets it to go. We're tied now, 66. All sixes on the floor, on the court, on the scoreboard. In the corner, Lobotwitz gets it to Cameron Fox, can't get it to go, gets his own rebound, then loses it. Bayhawks need to look to slow it down here.
It turns out Jernigan did not foul out. He's still on the court.
Here's a pick set by Baker. There's going to be a foul, and it looks like it's on Mass Bay.
Looks like it was on Mystery Man number 14.
Mystery Man number 14 commits the foul, and it's number 2 on him. And Marcus McCarthy will step up to the line.
So it's definitely not what he wants to do. I mean, if you can probably tell if he's not even on the roster sheet, he's probably not getting a lot of minutes. So it's definitely not something you want to do with as little playing time as you get.
That's for sure. But he's down here when it's crunch time, when it's winning time. McCarthy makes the first free throw. Both free throws made. So BCC, who's shot the ball miserably from the free throw line, has made their last four. Big shots, too. When it counts, here comes that trap. They got the trap in the corner. Ooh, that's a tough call.
Bayhawks
playing immense inspired defense, and that one looked to be questionable.
And McCarthy's mad at himself. He might be mad at himself. He might be mad at the refs, but one thing for sure, he's definitely mad.
A little incidental contact right there. I mean, the referee's all over it, so... Bayhawks lead by 2.
There goes the Bayhawks bench again.
Lobotwitz buries it. Jars it in to pull within 1. 2:22 left in Fall River.
Lobotwitz with a chance to tie it.
Fans starting to get more into it. Bayhawks bench into it, but Lobotwitz with 2 clutch free throws. So now we're seeing clutch free throws by both teams. Both teams being a lot better from the free throw line. 68-68. Another timeout on the court, this time by Coach Drob Delalu. 2:22 left to play. Tied at 68. Both teams in the double bonus. If you're just joining us, we're all deadlocked here. And now this game's going down to the wire. And goodness gracious, Craig, I tell you what, BCC has not shot well from the free throw line all day. They've barely gotten there. But free throws by Armani Baker and Marcus McCarthy are clutch free throws. I mean, goodness gracious. Talk about make it and when it counts. They certainly have done that, and you got to, you know, hats off to those guys.
Yeah, definitely improvement. Sometimes it takes a little bit to get your groove going, and you guys got to say to yourself, you know, I'm trying too hard. I'm trying to do too much. I just need to do what I know what to do and just be able to make those. You know?
Do your job.
Do your job, exactly.
As one.
I'm fumbling on my words.
As one, yeah, do your job. It's all right. First game of the season.
Yeah.
Getting the kinks out. Hey. Getting all the bugs out of this, out of the first game. Yep. Letting it all hang out. But we definitely got an exciting game for you. The game was what it's all about. It's what talks here, so.
You do got to kind of wonder, though, how different the game would be if number 55 got left in, the big man.
Him coming out of the game definitely changed the approach with the Bayhawks and how they approach with their offense. You see them driving more to the hole. You see them less intimidated to go to the hole. And they get a lot more makes. You see McCarthy drive into the lane. You see Marcus. You see Mr. Pope there go into the hole. You see these guys. That big presence was a factor early on. When he was in the game, it definitely was a factor. and the Bayhawks are taking advantage of him being out of the game. 68-68. Bayhawks with the basketball. Chance to take the lead. 15 on the shot clock. Here's Pope. Over to his backcourt mate right now, McCarthy. 7 on the shot clock. In the corner, Mendes has a shot. It's good! And he's fouled! And the crowd is loving it. Del Lue pushes his team back on the sideline there before they go on the court. That shot is good. Are they calling, was it a three?
It looked like a two to me, but nope, they fixed it.
They fixed it.
It was definitely a two.
I definitely thought, even from this vantage point, I knew it was a two.
He has a chance to add a couple more points on the board, though.
Danny Mendes has had a rough game. And another free throw. 5 consecutive free throws made down the stretch by the Bayhawks.
And he is telling Mass Bay, I am here to play and I am here to win.
Danny Mendes, one of the better players for the Bayhawks. Wow. Him and his box. Cuts it to within one. Big shot there. Got that one to go. Minute and a half to play. Both teams bringing their A game now. Driving to the hole was Pope. Kicks it back up to McCarthy. Loses the basketball. Looks like he didn't know what to do with it. Davis all the way to the... misses it.
It was a very blatant foul on that one.
Late foul. Davis lost control of it, but he'll go to the line for two and a chance to take the lead. Holy moly. It's getting hot in here. It's been hot in here. Davis, both teams being clutched now at the free throw line. Making it when it counts.
It's definitely hot in here, but both teams definitely having to chill down.
Exactly.
Another timeout call.
That foul must be on. The timeout must have been taken by Rob Del Lue as he's trying to ice Justin Davis right now. 71-71. Davis makes that free throw. He'll be shooting one more. So 1 minute and 19 seconds left to play, Craig. Both teams playing a lot, playing their best basketball, I think, down the stretch.
I tell you, that is a good strategy, though, just try to take him out of it. You know, he's loose, he's warm, he's ready to make shots. If you're able to take him out of that, even just for 1 second, throw his game off, you might just miss the deciding point. Or maybe not the deciding point, but the go-ahead point.
Well, we'll see here once they come out of that timeout. You know, obviously if he misses it, it's a good decision by Coach Rob Del Lue. If he makes it, either way.
Either way, he's at least able to probably calm down his team a little bit.
I love what I'm seeing out of the Bayhawks and going to their press, going into their trap. Both teams playing really good defense. This is only game two of the year for the Bayhawks. Their first game was against Quinsigamond. They won 87-75 last week. This is their second game of the year. It's a home opener. Tied up, Justin Davis makes it. So there goes that, 72-71. Getting loud in here.
The Pope was able to hang on to that. Now is not the time for mistakes.
Bayhawks getting into their offense. Lots of motion here. 10 on the shot clock. Desmond Jernigan at the top of the key. They're going to go to Baker. Strong move. If it is, that's his move. Armani Baker gives the Bayhawks the lead, 73-72. And now this gym is starting to get a playoff feeling here. Lobotwitz to Fox. They get inside of Cameron.
That was a big reach
Fox
right there.
Back out to Davis for three. No good. Coming off is Fox. Strong move up and in. Ooh. Cameron Fox with the big rebound and the putback.
Fox with probably the most important board of the game right now.
Yes, that was huge.
And he gets a foul call.
That was huge as the Bucks bench exploded there. Davis with the miss.
And this could
the
be big
turn of events. Cameron Jimenez Fox with the rebound, put the putback. Has a chance to put his team up two.
He's one of the better shooters on this team, so we'll see what he can do.
And he sinks it. All free throws down the stretch have been made by both teams.
Ooh.
20,
see that move
20
by
seconds on the shot clock. I mean, on the game clock. That's the three. Mendes, no good. There's a rebound. It's Baker to Jernigan. 8 seconds on the clock. Loose ball. What's going on? They call timeout?
Something. I don't know if it was a foul on the play. I don't know what. Looks like a foul on the play.
On?
I don't know. I'm not quite sure, but they're definitely calling something.
Do we have a possession arrow? Because that was kind of unclear at the end. It looks like it's going to make. Is it going to be Bayhawks basketball? 75-73. Either way, the Bayhawks are down two with 6.6 seconds left. So if they're going to the line, they have a chance to tie it.
For the Bayhawks' sake, they better hope it's their ball.
Referees converse in half court. I'm not really sure if we have an answer here.
They might not even know what happened.
There was a loose ball on the court that Danny Mendes came away with, and I'm not sure if there was a loose ball foul. I don't think so. I think the ball is going to stay here in the Bayhawks' possession. No word that there was a foul.
It wasn't a travel call. We've seen plenty of those, but actually both teams have been better with that in the last few minutes.
Yeah. 75-73. Wow.
6.6 seconds left.
Bayhawks had their chances. They had their looks. A lot of loose balls on the floor. The ball will stay here. So there isn't a foul. There isn't a foul. I was pretty sure of that. But it's going to stay here at Bayhawks basketball. They have a chance to win the game. The shot clock is off. 6.6 seconds left to inbound the ball. Is Pope. You want to deny if you're the Bucks. Going baseline, loses it out of bounds.
Good. So it's going to stay in Bristol's possession.
Good defense by the Bucks. If you're on the edge of the seat. And back at home, we are as well. Underneath their own basket. Almost knocked away. Loose ball on the floor. Coming away with it in a travel. Oh, my goodness.
They might have one chance just to get the ball
they
away and
might
pop
have
off
a
one shot.
Shot. Unbelievable. Nobody can hold on to the basketball here. 0.4 seconds left. Someone has to get a clear open shot.
Just a breakaway and a shot could work.
You got to throw it in. What are you doing?
That's
going to
be
the game. And the Mass Bay Community College has come in. Mass Bay Community College has come in, and they have upset Bristol Community College on their home floor and their home opener. Unbelievable.
Just not a good decision with
what
that last
a game.
Play.
75-73, Craig. What happened there on the last play there? The last sequence of possession there. The Bayhawks had the ball seemingly for the last 20 seconds. That ball was like a bar of soap.
He was just you could see it in his eyes. He looked like he just panicked. He just threw it up, probably hoping for the best. Maybe thought someone could get it, pop a shot, but it just didn't work. And all Mass Bay really had to do with 0.4 seconds left in the game. All they really had to do was just make contact, get it away enough so that way it's impossible for the Bayhawks to get possession, put up a shot. You only need two to tie it, three to win it. So it just didn't work. Trying to go deep, and it doesn't always work. You know, probably could have tried to go low with it maybe better, try to get a breakaway in for a two, go to overtime.
Well, they just seemingly couldn't hold on to the basketball. They had a couple of loose balls there that happened to – they kept losing the basketball. They kept getting it back, even on the last couple plays there.
Yeah, the last 30 seconds, just really couldn't hang on to it. Just like someone like buttered the basketball. It was just going everywhere.
They couldn't even get a clean look. Mm. They had their chances. They kept getting the ball back. They kept getting second and third chances. You've seen the Bayhawks travel. I mean, the Bucks traveled there at the end. I mean, it's, they had so many chances to get it done, and they couldn't get it done. So 75-73, Mass Bay Community College comes in here and defeats the Bristol Community College Bayhawks in their home court, in their home opener. It's an upset for sure. 75-73. So for David Cardoza and Craig Salvatore here at Bishop Conley High School here in Fall River, Massachusetts, the Mass Community College, the Mass Bay Community College Bucks, 75. Your Bristol Community College Bayhawks, 75-73. Stay tuned for more Bayhawks basketball in the future. Good night, everybody.